Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Chemistry Unplugged. This is the fifth part of quantum mechanics study. In this video we will discuss about simple harmonic oscillator, how we can calculate its wave function, energy value, its comparison with classical mechanical studies, 2D and 3D simple harmonic oscillator, degeneracy calculation and virial theorem. This topic is very, very important for the point of view of CSIR, NET and GATE. But please subscribe to my channel and click on bell icon for future notifications. So let's start a video. 1D simple harmonic oscillator, one dimensional simple harmonic oscillator. Simple harmonic oscillator is the oscillator in which a single particle oscillates to and fro about its equilibrium position. So we have a particle of mass m and it is oscillating to and fro to the up position or a equilibrium position. This particle is following Hooke's law, according to which a force, restoring force, is acting on this particle and this force is directly proportional to the displacement. And we have placed a negative sign before the x because direction of force and displacement is always opposite to each other. We can also write F is equals to minus kx, where k is the force constant and negative value denotes opposite direction of force and displacement. We can also calculate potential energy of this particle by integrating force with respect to displacement. And this is negative integration of f dx. So we will write the value of f here, minus kx dx, and it comes out 1 by 2 kx square. So potential energy of the particle is equals to half kx square. And because this equation is following the pattern of y is directly proportional to x square, and in this type of graph we draw a relationship between y, that is v, and x, and this graph is like a parabola. So the relationship between displacement and potential energy is denoted by parabola graph, and the frequency of this oscillating particle is 1 by 2 pi under root of k upon m. K is force constant and m is mass of the particle. According to the classical mechanical studies, the displacement x is given by a sine 2 pi nu t. Nu is frequency of oscillation, and from this equation we can calculate the velocity dx over dt. And we know that potential energy is equals to half kx square. And from this value of V, we can also calculate kinetic energy. And total energy will be the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy. So potential energy is half kx square. And kinetic energy is obtained by placing the value of V after taking the differentiation of x with respect to t. So the final value of total energy is half k a square. We are not going in details of classical mechanical derivations, but simply outcome is that the total energy is equals to half k a square. A is the amplitude of oscillation, potential energy is half kx square, and total energy is half k a square. Then what are the outcomes of classical mechanics studies? So this is the oscillation of simple harmonic oscillator. So, and the total energy is sum of potential energy and kinetic energy. So at the equilibrium position where x is 0, means displacement is 0, then potential energy will be 0. In that case, the total energy of the molecule is only kinetic energy. And at maximum displacement position, the potential energy will be maximum because x has its maximum value here. So the total energy will be equals to potential energy, and kinetic energy will be 0 at this point. And because kinetic energy is equals to half mv, Therefore, velocity will be zero at this point. When a particle has zero velocity, means it will spend maximum time at this position. So, in simple harmonic oscillation, the mass, the particle will spend maximum time at extreme position. While at equilibrium position, because total energy is equal to kinetic energy, therefore velocity will be maximum. And when the particle has maximum velocity, it will spend minimum time here. So these are the outcomes, main outcomes of classical mechanics. Now we will take quantum mechanics, and for this we will use Schrodinger equation for simple harmonic oscillator. Time independent Schrodinger equation is d square psi over dx square plus 8 pi square m h square e minus v psi is equals to 0. So here we will write the value of potential energy, which is half kx square. So this equation will become d square psi over dx square 8 pi square m h square e minus half kx square psi is equals to 0. This equation can be written like this also, d square psi over dx square 8 pi square m e h square minus 4 pi square m kx square upon h square psi is equals to 0. So after taking many assumptions and a lengthy calculation, the final equation of psi is under root of alpha upon 2n, n factorial under root of pi whole 1 by 2 hn e minus alpha x square by 2. This is the final equation and we need only this equation. So we will not go in the depth of how we can determine this equation. And in this equation, alpha is m omega upon h bar. And we know that h bar is equals to h upon 2 pi and omega is equal to under root of k upon m. Means omega is simply nu into 2 pi. Omega is also known as angular frequency. Then next thing is hn. Hn is known as Hermite polynomials, and we will understand how we can use this Hermite polynomial. First few Hermite polynomials are, for n is equals to 0, h0 is equals to 1. For n is equals to 1, h1 is equals to 2y. And for n is equals to 2, h2 is equals to 4y square minus 2. N is equals to 3. For n is equals to 3, h3 is equals to 8y cube minus 12y, where y is equals to under root of alpha multiplied by x. The energy value for simple harmonic oscillator is given by n plus 1 by 2 h nu, where nu is equals to 1 by 2 pi under root of k upon m. N can have 0, 1, 2, 3 or any integral value. Means when n is 0, the particle has an energy which is equals to half k, half h nu. Means at 0 quantum number, the particle has energy. It is not standstill, it has some energy which is known as zero point energy. And this value is equals to half h nu. We can also calculate the energy difference between two successive levels. Suppose for first excited state, the energy value is E1 is equals to 1 plus 1 by 2 h nu. And at second excited state, it will be 2 plus 1 by 2 h nu. So E1 will become equals to 3 by 2 h nu. And E2 is equals to 5 by 2 h nu. And the difference between E2 and E1 is equals to h nu. And the difference between two successive vibrational energy levels is always h nu. So the energy difference is constant, that is h nu. So what are the conclusions of quantum mechanics? First is vibrational energy of simple harmonic oscillator can never be zero. According to the classical mechanics, the energy value, the potential energy is zero at equilibrium state. But according to quantum mechanics, a vibrational energy of simple harmonic oscillator can never be zero. It can never be standstill particle. Even at ground state, at n is equals to 0, it has some energy which is known as zero point energy. So at equilibrium position, according to the classical mechanics, at equilibrium position, potential energy is zero. But according to quantum mechanics, at x is equals to 0, particle has energy equal to half h nu. And this energy is the sum of, this total energy is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. We will see later how total energy is the sum of kinetic and potential energy. It is given by virial theorem that the total energy of simple harmonic oscillator is the sum of kinetic and potential energy. Equal contribution of kinetic and potential energy is there. So the total energy is equals to twice of potential energy, means potential energy of the particle at x is equals to 0 will be 1 by 4 h nu, means it is not 0 at x is equals to 0. Second is, it exists in quantized form. The energy exists in quantized form. Third is, the energy difference between two successive energy levels is same, that is h nu. Then we will see the graphical representation of psi n psi square. For n is equals to 0, psi will be like this. For n is equals to 1, it will be like this. For n is equals to 2, it will be like this. And for n is equals to n, suppose this is the way of representation of wave function. Now we will represent different probability, finding of probability at different values of n. So for n is equals to 0, the probability will be maximum at equilibrium position, while when we start increase quantum number, the probability density will be highest at extreme positions. Means for lower quantum number, suppose for n is equals to 0, the maximum probability of finding particle is at equilibrium position. While when we increase the quantum number, the maximum probability of finding the particle at extreme positions. This is according to the classical mechanics, that the probability of finding the particle is maximum at extreme position, because we know that total energy is equals to potential energy at extreme position, kinetic energy is zero, so the particle is spent maximum time at extreme position. So classical mechanics say that maximum probability of finding the particle is at extreme position, while quantum mechanics says that it is maximum at equilibrium position. So this is for n, when the quantum numbers are small. But for higher quantum numbers, the findings of quantum and classical mechanics are same for higher quantum numbers. So this effect is known as tunneling, that the probability of finding quantum mechanical particle in classical region is called tunneling. Means when classical and quantum mechanics are giving same result, we will call it the tunneling effect. And this is true for higher quantum numbers. Now we will see what are the symmetric and asymmetric wave functions. Wave functions for which quantum numbers are even will be symmetric wave functions, while the wave functions for which quantum number is odd will be asymmetric wave functions. So this is the equation for wave function of simple harmonic oscillator, and in this the wave function is directly proportional to exponential minus alpha x square by 2. Means when x approaches infinity, then wave function falls to 0. Wave function falls off exponentially to 0 as x approaches infinity. So this will be the curve. It is a Gaussian curve. It is known as Gaussian curve. And it denotes that psi is not 0 even for higher values of x. The wave function is not 0 even at higher value of x. Means there is some probability of finding the particles at even very large values of x. And this is in contrast to some classical harmonic oscillator which has a finite amplitude. Then psi is symmetric or even for the n values, even n values, and psi is asymmetric or odd for odd n values. So we can simply determine by looking at the values of psi whether it has even number or odd number to tell it is its symmetric and asymmetric nature. But for complex wave functions or complex functions, how we can determine their even and odd nature? So a function is even when fx is equals to f minus x, and it is odd when fx is equals to minus f minus x. So this type of questions can be asked in the examination. Then they will ask you to find out whether a function is even, odd, or neither even nor odd. So how we can determine it? Suppose we have a function x sin x. So we will determine its f minus x function, and if fx is equals to f minus x, then it will be even. So for suppose this function f minus x will be minus x sin minus x. We will simply place a negative sign before x and then we will calculate it. So sin minus x is minus sin x. So minus minus sign will be plus, then it will be minus sin x. So in this case fx is equals to f minus x. So it is an even function. Let's take another example in which a function is e to the power minus x square cos x. So we will calculate its f minus x. So e minus minus x whole square cos minus x. So minus x square will be x square, e minus x square, and cos minus x is cos x. So it is also an even function because both of them are same. Next example in which we have a function e to the power minus e to the power ix, and it can also be written like this, cos x plus I sin x. So now we will determine its f minus x function. So it will be cos minus x plus I sin minus x. So cos minus x is cos x and sin minus x is minus sin x. So this equation will be cos x minus I sin x. So it is not equal to fx, and even it is not equal to minus f minus x. It is a different equation. So neither this function is even nor it is odd. Next is 2DSHO, two dimensional simple harmonic oscillator. The energy value of 2DSHO is given by E is equals to nx plus 1 by 2 h nu plus ny plus 1 by 2 h nu. So it will become nx plus ny plus 1 h nu. And we can calculate the wave function by multiplying the wave function for x with wave function for y. So it will be product of psi x psi y. So first we will try to determine degeneracy value for different values of n. So for n is equals to 0, nx is equals to 0, ny is equals to 0, degeneracy will be 1. For 1, 0 combination, we can have 2 type of combination. 1 0 and 0 1. So it will have two possible combinations. So degeneracy is 2. Next energy level is 3 h nu, for which we can have 3 types of combination: 1 1, 0 2, 2 0. So the degeneracy value is 3. Next energy level will be 4 h nu, because the energy difference between two successive energy levels is h nu. Therefore, next will be 4 h nu. So the possible combinations of quantum number will be 1 2, 2 1, 3 0 and 0 3. So degeneracy will be 4. So now suppose we want to calculate wave function for 1 0 energy level. 1 0 means 1, n x is equals to 1 and n y is equals to 0. So we will simply multiply these two wave functions. These are the equations for simple harmonic oscillator. Now I will place the value of n in this equation. For n is equals to 1, 2 to the power 1 is 1, 1 factorial is 1. So it will become like this. For h, n is equals to 1, the equation is 2y. So y and y is equals to under root of alpha dot x. So it will be 2 under root alpha x e to the power minus alpha x square by 2. Then next n value is 0. So it will become under root of alpha under root of pi to the power 1 by 2. 2 to the power 0 is 1. And hn, h0 is also 1. So this will be like this. Now I will simply multiply these two equations. So the final equation will be like this. So similarly, we can calculate wave function of 2D SHO for different values of n. Next is three-dimensional SHO, three-dimensional simple harmonic oscillator. Its energy value will be nx plus 1 by 2 h nu plus ny plus 1 by 2 h nu and plus nz 1 by 2 h nu. So when we will sum these three terms, this will be nx plus ny plus nz plus 3 by 2 h nu. And the wave function will be product of psi x, psi y and psi z. Now the calculation of degeneracy for 3D SHO is not easy like 2D and 1D SHO. So we will use an equation for this, where n is the sum of nx, ny and nz. And the value of degeneracy g will be equal to n plus 1 into n plus 2 by 2. So we will simply place the value of n in this equation and we will get the value of g. Now suppose we have an energy value of 13 h nu by 2 and it has been asked what will be its n and g value. So first we will compare it with the equation n plus 3 by 2 h nu. So n will become equals to 5 and we will place the value of n in the equation of g. So it will be 5 plus 1 into 5 plus 2 by 2. So the value of g is equals to 21. The value of g can be very very high, so don't be confused with that. Simply place the value of n and determine g. The question is, determine the value of x for which the first excited state wave function of SHO exhibit a maximum. Further show that this value of x is 0.577 times of maximum displacement. So first we will write down the equation of psi for simple harmonic oscillator. And you have to determine the value of x for first excited state wave function. First excited state wave function means n is equals to 1. N is equals to 0 means ground state. First excited state is n is equals to 1. So we will place the value of n is equals to 1 in this equation. And for n is equals to 1, polynomial factor is, Hermite polynomial is 2 under root alpha dot x. We can also write it like this, alpha by pi having power 1 by 4 under root of 2 alpha dot x e to the power minus alpha x square by 2. And in the equation, we have to determine the maximum, when the particle will exhibit maximum, for which value of x particle will exhibit maximum. And to determine maximum, you have to simply differentiate psi with respect to x and place it equals to 0. So we will determine the differentiation of psi 1. So we will take its differentiation, and I am just writing the final term here, and it is equals to e minus alpha x square, e to the power minus alpha x square by 2 minus alpha x square e to the power minus alpha x square by 2 is equals to 0. I have not written all the terms here. So this can be written like this also. We will take e to the power minus alpha x square by 2 as common, and when we divide it by 0, it will also be 0. So 1 minus alpha x square is equals to 0. So x is equals to 1 by root alpha, and we know that alpha is equals to m omega upon h bar. And the next part is, show that this value of x is 0.577 times of maximum displacement. So we will write the energy value for maximum displacement. It will be half kx maximum square, and according to quantum mechanics, the energy value is n plus 1 by 2 h nu. So these two terms are energy values are equal, so we can simply equate them, and we can also write it like this by placing the value of nu here. And for first excited state, because n is equal to 1, so it will be 3 by 2 h bar. H upon 2 pi is, can be written as h bar root k upon m. So x maximum square will be equals to 3 h bar upon k root k upon m. I can also write it like this, 3 h bar upon under root of mk, and alpha is equals to m omega upon h bar, and omega is equals to under root of k upon m. So it can be written like this also, under root of mk upon h bar. So I can place the value of alpha here. It will be 3 by alpha. And so this will be equal to 3 x square. So x will be equal to root 3 x maximum. Then here we have some conclusions of simple harmonic oscillator studies. These are few terms, you can memorize them. The expectation value of px square is equal to n plus 1 by 2 alpha h bar square. The expectation value of x square is equal to n plus 1 by 2 1 upon alpha. So for potential energy, this value will be half k x square. So I will place the value of average x square in this equation. So it will be 1 by 2 k n plus 1 by 2 1 upon alpha. Similarly, we can also calculate the value of kinetic energy using momentum. So px square upon 2m, it will be px square upon 2m. I will place the expectation value of px square in this equation. So the kinetic energy will be equal to n plus 1 by 2 alpha h bar square upon 2m. Now we will take virial theorem. What the virial theorem says, according to the virial theorem, The expectation value of kinetic energy, which is denoted by T, is equal to the expectation value of potential energy. At any instance, in simple harmonic oscillator, the expectation or average value of potential energy is equal to the expectation or average value of kinetic energy. And we know that total energy is the sum of kinetic and potential energy. So it will be twice of kinetic energy, then kinetic energy will be 1 by 2 total energy, expectation value of total energy. Or the potential energy is also equals to 1 by 2 average of or expectation value of total energy. We can also prove this by placing the value of expectation value of V and T in this equation. So the average value of V is equal to 1 by 2 K n plus 1 by 2 1 upon alpha. So I can write the value of alpha in this equation and then I will calculate it. Alpha is equal to m omega upon h bar. So it will be or m under root of m k upon h bar. So it will be like this. So I can also write this equation like this. Then I will calculate the expectation value of kinetic energy by placing the value of alpha, that is under root of mk upon h bar. So it is also equal to the value expectation value of potential energy. So it is the proof that the average value of kinetic energy is equal to the average value of potential energy for nth level of quantum number or nth energy level. So this is the proof of virial theorem. I hope this video will be helpful for you. So please subscribe to my channel and click on bell icon for future notification, and keep watching my channel. Share it with your friends. Thank you.